You know, if Buffalo loses tonight, Rick, it's going to make this weekend rather fun, isn't it? And I'll bring up a funny situation for you. What if? You know, there's a lot of what ifs in this game. I don't think it's any secret that the Boston Bruins don't want to play the Buffalo Sabres. What if this boils down to a game in Boston Sunday night? A Whaler win. Uh-oh.
Lemieux gets the puck away from Young. He's in alone. He's gone.
That's the hat trick for Mario Lemieux. I'll tell you what. He looked rather confident going in this time, considering he got beat by Whitmore on his previous breakaway. As you see some of the hats to the ice.
Merely his ninth hat trick of the season.
That's a shorthanded goal, don't forget, also. Watch how confidently he plays. It's a fake, then to his forehand and under Kay Whitmore. I'll tell you, that was no contest. I'll tell you one thing, if the game ends up this way, and Lemieux is 1-for-2 in breakaways, that's a big victory for Kay Whitmore. I was reading an interview, here's a fake, then a ho-hum. But he has had 4 penalty shots, and he's 4-for-4. You know, that's a terrific record.
He's getting a standing ovation for scoring that shorthanded goal, his 13th, and that sets a new NHL mark.
That's an NHL mark.
Yep, he was tied with Gretzky at 12 prior to that goal. One more hat trick. Even with 2 games left after tonight, he still could do it. He would tie another Gretzky record with his 10th hat trick of the season.
This is a dumb question, Rick. Can you get 2 hat tricks in 1 game, or they only count as 1?
Well, he had a 5-goal game, but remember that one against New Jersey? Here's a pass in front. Ferraro chops it wide. 38 seconds remaining on the penalty. The Whalers still want to go to work with this man advantage and a 7-4 lead now with 8:05 to go in the game or in the third period. You never know with the Penguins.